Welcome to the React Stepper component tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain how to create a React app and add the Syncfusion React Stepper component to it. In general, the Stepper component allows users to navigate through a series of steps in a web application. It displays steps, highlights the current one, and enables users to move between them. It offers features like different step types, orientation, linear flow, label positions, and template customization. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the npx create react app command. I provide the app name as my app. And I want to create the React app with TypeScript, so I add the template TypeScript. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the Syncfusion React Stepper component, I type the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-navigations --save. For using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. The trial license key is mandatory for React products to avoid the licensing warning. To see where to generate a trial license key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. Then I import the React Stepper component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package and include the Stepper component tag. Stepper component allows to add each step by using step directive tag inside the steps directive tag. For that, I import steps directive and step directive from Syncfusion React Navigations package and add 4 step directive tags inside the steps directive tag. Next, I need to add the CSS reference for the stepper component. So I open the app.css file, remove the default code, and add the material theme references. Now I run this application using the npm start command. In this example, you can see the stepper component render with 4 steps. By default, the stepper component renders the steps with numeric numbers, but it can be customized. I'm going to configure the steps with icons and labels. In the stepper component, I can add icons and labels using the icon CSS and label properties of the step directive tag. In the first step, I set the icon CSS property to SF icon cart and the label property to cart. Similarly, I assign values for the icon CSS and label properties for the remaining 3 steps. Next, I add custom styles for icons. For that, first I open the app.css file. Then I define a custom font name default using the @fontface rule. After that, I set the font family property for elements with class names starting with this F icon to use my custom font. Next, we specify the content for each icon by using that before pseudo element and Unicode characters. Now in the example, steps are rendered with icons and labels. It makes the stepper more informative and makes it easier to track the process. Let's have a quick summary. In this video, I have shown you how to add a Syncfusion stepper component to a React application and add icons and labels to it. You can get a working example of this from the component's documentation page linked in the description for this video. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.